by Mr. Conrad, seconded by Mr. Boyd. Any questions or concerns? Wait a minute, Ms. Howard. Thank you. I didn't see you. Let me get your light on. You have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I just wanted to ask the chairman of the committee or MPD exactly what would we be using the funds for in the area of juvenile justice and delinquency prevention.
All right, we have a representative from the police department coming to the podium.
I'm Rowena Adams. I'm deputy chief with Administrative Services and Police Services Division. These funds are sub-awarded from the Memphis Shelby County Crime Commission for the furtherance of the National Forum on Youth Violence. The commission also coordinates with the Shelby County Schools in the Positive Behavior in the Schools program as prescribed by the Department of Education and the Department of Justice.
So do we know how the city's going to utilize those funds?
I don't have that information.
You call, Ms. Chair. Okay. I think Councilman Collins does.
All right, fine. Collins, go right in.
The city is utilizing these funds as a conduit through the Crime Commission because the Crime Commission is a 501c3, and the Department of Justice does not issue grants to 501c3 to police departments, so the police department allows the Crime Commission to hold the funds so they can utilize the funds. That's how it works.
Okay, that's fine. I just wanted to know exactly, because of my involvement with juvenile justice, I just wanted to know exactly what program were we planning to use it for?
Well, if that in was this particular case, those funds are going to be used to hire a researcher or evaluator to look at the rate of truancy in Shelby County. There are disparities between what is being reported to the State Department of Ed, what is being reported to the Memphis Police Department and other agencies regarding truancy. And so this evaluator or researcher will be the one to pull all these agencies together to get true numbers and accurate data so that we could address truancy in Shelby County.
Okay, Mr. Chair, I'm going to support this resolution request, but I would like to ask, before we approve the minutes in 2 weeks, if we could find out exactly what the city is going to be utilizing the funds for, because $222,000 is not a...
All of that money is not going to be for an evaluator, but you can get the breakdown from...
Right, I just think, Ms. Chair, we need the breakdown on exactly how we're going to be utilizing that money, because if there are going to be programs, I want to make sure that all of the council members have an opportunity to share with their respective districts and communities the opportunities that may be coming up.
Ms. Halbert, this has been requested, these and the other four items, for same night minutes.
Well, can we move it to the end and we have someone to call or tell us what the, Mr. Chair.
I would try to accommodate you.
Wait a minute.
I would do that.
Let me say this because I kind of heard some huffing and puffing. You all, we're asking to accept money and use it, and that's fine. But if no one can tell us what we're using the money for and somebody just happens to ask on the record, then that's a problem. We have to know how we're going to use the money.
I agree with that, Ms. Halbert, and here's my position. I believe there is a breakdown of the funding levels in the grant. And for obviously, Chief does not have that break. Do you have that, Chief?
No.
Obviously, she doesn't have it or she would have presented it to you. And that's unfortunate, but there is a breakdown of the funding levels, who gets what, how much it goes where, and so forth and so on. I can't tell you that this particular funding is I do know that most of that funding is going to be addressed in the 38127 and 128 zip codes and the 38141 zip codes. There is a high rate of truancy in the Raleigh-Fraser community and a high rate of truancy in the Southeast Memphis community that I do know of, and so most of those funds will be directed to that area.
And that's a challenge for me, Mr. Chair, Councilman Collins, because all of us have seen the issues that our juveniles have been getting involved in lately, and if there are going to be some juvenile justice programs that are implemented or offered, then I would like to see it shared, because I have a couple of areas in District 4. And I know there are some other areas where there's a high rate I mean, even the Kroger incident was right outside of District 4, and a number of District 4 children were involved in that. And so was this an item in today's committee?
Yes.
So it was in today's committee. We don't have any documentation to talk about the breakdown, but we got to accept the $222,000 and approve it right now.
Well, here's also what I know. The grant runs out September 2015. The work has to be started by December 2014 in order to pull the funds from the federal government. And this is based on the information that I received from the Memphis Police Department personnel when I found out that this grant was coming, and I shared this information with the chair of the committee and the chair of the council. And I specifically went to them 2 days prior to this meeting and said, listen, this is what you're getting ready to get from this Memphis Police Department grant request. And they graciously said, okay, they call it the triple play. So they graciously said, okay, we would do this. Now, I submit to you, I understand there may be some issues in District 4. We got truancy all over Shelby County. But unfortunately, when you're dealing with grants with the Department of Justice and delinquency, they want you to drill down specifically your target area. And these two target areas were chosen, and the federal government decided to award this grant. Now, if I'm going to support it because I'm going to help try to fight truancy in Shelby County. Now, maybe what I would suggest is that you contact the Crime Commission and their evaluator and see if they're able to assist you to get some research done in District 4. That's what we do. We don't worry about where it is. I'm hoping that we can get truancy advanced and dealt with all across this county.
We who?
We, this council. We, the city leaders of this city. We need to address truancy like we address potholes, like we address crime, like we address rape kits and all that stuff.
Mr. Chair, did you have anything to add before I make my final comment? Because this is a
yes, I was just
challenge.
Going to say that we could give you an itemized list of what we plan to spend that money on before we actually spend it.
Okay, let me go on the record. I'm going to support this, but I will admit that I am very concerned because whatever this project is, all of us have not had an opportunity to have access to find out exactly who's doing this project, what the projects are, where the project is going to be implemented, and that makes me a little nervous. You know, the fact that we're getting it, you all heard this for the first time in committee today, and we weren't even, I mean, I'll just say it with all due respect, we weren't smart enough to bring the list of exactly how we're planning to utilize these funds. If we get tapped by the federal government asking us, you know, about the day that we approved it, nobody up here knows anything about it. I will support the motion because it's $222,000, but in the next meeting, Mr. Chair, I would like for us to find out exactly what this is, who all's involved, how is it being implemented, and how is it going to be expanded or help the entire city of Memphis.
Ms. Halbert, thank you so very much.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
All right. I have lights on from Mr. Harris and then Mr. Boyd. Mr. Harris, you have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I think the chief has already answered my point is we could approve the accepting of these grant funds, but delay spending these grant funds until we get the breakdown. So the appropriation, come to us again for the appropriation. This is to Mr. Wade. Is that already anticipated in the usual process of grant funds that there will be a resolution to accept the grant funds and then later a resolution or approval process by this body to spend the grant funds?
You can do it both ways.
You can do it either way.
Yeah.
Okay, so then I would just move to modify this resolution to add that before any funds are spent, the Memphis City Council approves it.
Go ahead, Mr. Wade.
Remember, wait a problem. Minute. Hold it. I hear some members up here talking. I need to hear Mr. Wade. Thank you, sir.
I'll ask Councilman Collins to chime in. If the grant is a conditional grant to be used for those specific areas, I'm sure they can specify within those areas what they would use it for, but I don't think we can mess around and disqualify the grant by.
Oh, I think we're going to spend it in 38127 and 38128. It's just whether or not okay. We have another vote before we spend it in 38127 and 38128. I'm not suggesting we negotiate because I agree with Mr. Collins that wherever kids are found, where they're truant, then we need to invest.